did the premise of the show freak you out as much as it's freaking me out? Because I'm gonna have nightmares over this. I'm not.
Yeah, it's spooky, huh?
Yeah, it's so weird.
You're like living in your kitchen, just listening to everything you say, and yeah, just write it all down. It's crazy.
No, I'm really excited about it.
Yeah.
Just in terms of, because it's stuff that I just have read about it a lot and listened to a lot of stuff about AI and stuff, and I just think that it's something that people are not aware of enough, you know, and so the fact that there's going to be this, like, mainstream show that's going to be addressing this issue that a lot of people are not talking about, I just think is important, you know, so it's not just your usual, like, you know, detective show. Not that detective shows are great and stuff, but it's just you haven't seen something like this, and I find that incredibly exciting. And I think that the threat that is posed in the show is something that is very much a reality, or could be.
A lot of these things, they go way off into space or into the future, and like they talk about like robots with red eyes and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
What I think that the directors and creators have done so well is they've made it really grounded in reality. Yes. Like, what if it happens tomorrow? You know, as opposed to with spaceships.
I mean, it's not that far away. Like, we're not, like, AI is doing so much in our day-to-day lives that we're not even aware of, you know, because we've grown so accustomed to it and our reliance on it and stuff like that. So, yeah, I just think it's an important topic to be talking about, and that, you know, there's so many concerns right now, climate change, political stuff, you know, it's like AI is just looming in the background there. It's this, like, silent threat that people aren't talking about. It's just, if the robots take over, we're all fucked.
Exactly. Yeah. So what are your characters?
I play a guy named CM, who's a computer hacker, and he's kind of on work release. He's got like an ankle bracelet, so I don't know if he's there willingly. I don't think he is, but he's somehow burning off hours to pay penance for something he's done in his past. We're not quite sure yet.
And I play Gina, who is a data analyst, works at the FBI.
Oh. Yeah. Do they give you a backstory? I mean, do you really don't know what's happening to him?
I haven't heard yet. Okay. But I'm sure.
I'll find out at some point.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, is it basically a human-based drama, or is it more like a sci-fi type situation?
Well, that's what I think. It's more human-based. I think it's going to feel incredibly human. I mean, that's what's so creepy about these things is we call it Alexa, we call it Siri. I mean, it has a name. It has like it jokes with you now. Like, I mean, they've somehow humanized these things so much that we've started to lose some of our. We've become dehumanized somehow with each other. Like, you know.
Yeah, like people are proposing to Alexa. Like, that's a fact. There was an article out about it, how it's just like, what is this saying? And also the fact that, like, how it is altering the psychology of kids, that they're yelling at Alexa and they're being rude to it, and, like, dealing with the fact that Alexa is female voice and Siri is a female voice and all these things, and how that is...
I didn't think about that. What does that mean?
Yeah, well, I mean, what do you... Like, you have children who are yelling at women. Robots, like, why, you know, like, just put it out there. It's like you don't even think about that, but it's like that's very much what message are you sending out when you're allowing that dynamic to happen. So I think it is, people think of AI as this thing that's really far away and removed from our day-to-day lives, but it's not. And yeah, that is what the show does. Yeah.
So was that, I mean, at the very beginning, the appeal of it was that something that's current today, we need to know about this. Is that why you latched on?
Yeah. Well, it's. I was. I don't know if you guys. You know that show Chernobyl? So it came out, and there's this one thing that one of the guys says to the other guys, like, "How do we fix this problem?" And the other guy's like, "We've never faced this in like the existence of the planet, so we don't know. Like, we're facing this threat that we've never experienced." So I think that's what, like, this is talking about a threat that we haven't experienced yet, but we're very close to. We're on the, like, edge of entering that possibility. And so, yeah, that's what I just thought it was very current, relevant, important to talk about.
It's also fun. I mean, it's going to be like a thriller. In a
It's
going to be like a race against the clock and, like, you know, it's, to me, it feels like the Blob, you know, it's like this kind of faceless, nameless, bloodless thing that's just kind of consuming all aspects of our lives and trying to run from it or attack it or destroy it or whatever, but it doesn't have a name and you don't know where, you know what I mean? It's kind of in that tradition of kind of it's everywhere, like, you know what I mean? Very John Carpenter, you know?
Yeah.
And it's also like, it's Manny, it was like 24, you know, it's like shit's happening, like things have to get done and stuff. I just, I just get excited about the, like, the real things of it and how I, like I said, when I read the script, I was like, oh my god, this is so cool, this is all real shit, you know, like it's not like, I mean, he pulled it out of nothing, like it's so based in research and it's really cool that he made this, all this real stuff, very cool and like fast and shit's happening, oh my god,
car crashes.
Car crashes and how do we stop this and what's happening and like, whoa,
get to the chopper.
But you can't win the bottle of the battle or there won't be a second season, right? So
Well, I mean, it's, you know, it's kind of like a game of whack-a-mole, I think, a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, you could maybe grab, you know, put one out, but, you know, if this thing's out of the, you know, if the genie's out of the bottle.
Yeah, how do we?
It's out there now.
Yeah.
You know?
Interesting. So, are you normally a fan of sci-fi type stories?
I don't think I've ever done a sci-fi thing. Well, I just did a decent, that's a super, I don't think I've ever...
Yeah, sci-fi.
I like sci-fi stuff, yeah.
Yeah.
Would they call this sci-fi?
I don't know.
Sci-fi thriller? Is that what they, is that what it's in the books and stuff? Yeah. Do they describe it as sci-fi?
I think so.
Yeah.
I mean, like, in a future where robots take, and not robots, but AI takes over is, I think, considered sci-fi, but I'm so, like, into this, and I'm like,
yeah, we're so
sci-fi.
Like,
it's real. It's real.
There's no fiction, it's science.
Have you changed anything that you, your daily life with technology after starting your show that you're just like, okay, I need to step back in this aspect?
I'm just trying not to look at my phone every time I like have a, like, don't know what to do or don't have, like, it's like, it's so immediate to like look at this thing and then I look at it and there's, for what? So I go to my Instagram and I flip. I don't, it's so like, like after a while.
Yeah, I don't, I mean, I've always been very much like, I'm such a Luddite. Like, I have a, like, you know, my phone is like a 5S. Like, it's a really old, like, iPhone. If I could have a flip phone, I probably would. Like, so I've always been very wary of it and its effect on people. And it's, you see it immediately. And I remember a time where I was like, Facebook, what's that? Like, that's so, so stupid. Why would you be, like, friends with people who you're friends with in real life? I remember those words coming out of my mouth. And, like, holy cow. Like, it's just, it's insane.
Are you on the
Facebook?
I'm
on Facebook. I am. I know. And I have an Instagram account and I have all that shit, but like I'm very like aware of it and try not to go on it. Like I put my phone away. I want to be able to read for 3 hours straight without checking my phone. You know, like it's just,